to me, pa-ra-pa-pum-pum. The newborn king to see, pa-ra-pa-pum-pum. Our finest gifts we bring, pa-ra-pa-pum-pum, ra-pa-pum-pum, ra-pa-pum-pum.
Can it be
the newborn king to see, perhaps unseen? Our finest gifts we bring, to lay before the king, every child must be made aware. Every child must be made to care. Care enough for his fellow man to give all the love that he can.
Bring a baby, pa-rum-pa-pum,
will come true.
I stood beside him there, pa-rum-pa-pum-pum. I paid my tenth for him, pa-rum-pa-pum-pum. I paid my best for him,
pa-rum-pa-pum-pum-pum.
Welcome to our virtual carol service for what has certainly been a very strange year. COVID-19 has had a huge impact on all our lives, and for many it has been an extremely difficult and lonely time. As we prepare for the coming of Jesus this Advent, we look forward with a renewed sense of peace in our hearts and minds that the coming of the Saviour will bring new light and hope into our lives. Our clergy will now lead our ecumenical carol service for this Christmas season.
God our Father, you loved us so much that you sent your only Son, Jesus, born of the Virgin Mary, to save us and to lead us back to you. We pray that, with your blessing, this celebration of the birth of Jesus might be a sign of your presence and your love in our lives. This Advent season, open our hearts that we might receive Jesus in joy. Do always what he asks of us, and see him in those who need our love. We ask this in the name of Jesus, your beloved Son, who came to give peace to the world. Amen.
A reading from the book of Philippians. Rejoice in the Lord always. I will say it again, rejoice. Let your gentleness be evident to all. The Lord is near. Do not be anxious about anything. By prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, present your requests to God. And the peace of God, which transcends all understanding, will guard your hearts and minds in Christ Jesus. The word of the Lord.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. At that time of Caesar Augustus ordered a census to be taken throughout the whole of the empire. This was the first census when Quirinius was governor of Syria. Everyone had to travel to their own ancestral hometown to be accounted for. So Joseph went to the Galilean town of Nazareth, up to Bethlehem in Judea, David's town, for the census. As a descendant of David, he had to go there. He went with Mary, his fiancée, who was pregnant. While they were there, the time came for her to give birth. She gave birth to a son, her firstborn. She She wrapped him in a blanket and laid him in a manger, because there was no room in the inn. The Gospel of the Lord.
We pray for all who have found this last year very difficult due to the pandemic. We pray for peace in our hearts and minds this Christmas as we look forward in hope to brighter days ahead. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear us.
We remember all those who cannot make it home this Christmas or may have to spend Christmas alone. We pray that although we are apart, we may still feel connected in a meaningful way and be able to share the joy of the birth of Jesus and the blessings that this holy season brings. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear us.
As we look forward to the birth of Jesus with Christians all over the world, may it bring about everlasting peace and unity for all people, especially for all people ravaged by war. Lord, hear us.
We give thanks for all our skilled community who have given us peace of mind and kept us safe over the last few months. We especially pray for our skilled management, caretakers, cleaning and office staff who have worked so hard to keep us safe during this time. May they all have a restful Christmas. Lord, hear us.
Remember and give thanks for all our loved ones who have died, and we pray for all those who grieve this Christmas. Lord, comfort them during this lonely time. Lord, hear us.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
I have come to bring you peace, a message from Jesus our Saviour. I have come to bring you peace, not the peace of the season, for it is too fleeting, not the peace of the carol, for it is too nostalgic, not the peace of the greeting card, for it is too slick, not the peace of the crib, for it is too wistful. Rather, I have come to bring you peace, peace of the ordinary, the daily, the holy, peace for the worker, the driver, the student, peace in the office, the kitchen, the farm. I have come to bring you peace, the peace of accepting yourself as I fashioned you, the peace of knowing yourself as I know you, the peace of loving yourself as I love you, the peace of being yourself as I am who I am. I have come to bring you peace, the peace that warms you at the completion of a task, the peace that invades you at the close of the day, the peace that sustains you at the beginning of the day, the peace that reinforces you when you are reconciled with one another, the peace that touches you when your family is in order. Without peace, my coming is unfulfilled. Without peace, my birth is forgettable. Without peace, Christmas is a contradiction. I have come to bring you peace.
We pray, Lord God, that we all experience the gifts of love, joy, hope, and peace in our lives. May our time at Christmas be not just for ourselves, but for all of the people that we connect with. May we have the strength to bring God's kindness and peace into our world. May the witness of our life prepare us for the birth of Jesus this Christmas. And we ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Christ our Savior was born on Christmas
day, to save us all from Satan's powers when we've gone astray. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy, comfort and joy. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy. From God our Heavenly Father, a blessed angel's king, who on to certain shepherds brought tidings of the same. From that in Bethlehem was born a Son of God by name. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy, comfort and joy. Oh, tidings of comfort.